Hey folks, today we're going to use Hasura's event triggers and ChatGPT to create a custom instant user content moderation workflow. We're going to utilize the Docs Sample app, which is an e-commerce platform to take user reviews, moderate them with ChatGPT, and then execute some custom logic on our application. And we're going to do it all inside of 15 minutes. Here's a peek at what we're building. As a user submits a new review, Hasura will write that to our database. And by default, all new reviews are going to be hidden. We'll also have an event trigger listening for inserts to the reviews table, which will know to take that payload of that new data and hit our handler. The handler that we're writing today is going to be in JavaScript, but you can use any language or framework you like. So long as it's an HTTP service that handles requests and returns responses, you're good to go. Plus, this can be hosted anywhere. But today, we're going to use ngrok to tunnel this instance from our local machine to our Hasura project. The handler will do the heavy lifting and send the new review along with a prompt to ChatGPT. GPT is then going to use that information and tell the handler whether or not the content is appropriate, and our handler will either send a mutation to Hasura to update our review and make it visible, or, if the user's been naughty, create a new notification for that user, alerting them to their review status. Let's dive into it. As we were talking about a second ago, we're using the Docs Sample app, and you can see that right now we're on the page inside of documentation that focuses on this particular tutorial that we're doing today in this video. We have this block down here, and you'll find this in a lot of places like quick starts and recipes that we have throughout documentation, where you can actually click this button and do a one-click deploy to Hasura Cloud. I've already done that, so we can see this right here. This is really great because it takes care of going ahead and configuring all of your metadata, loading your seed data, everything. So it's literally a one-click deploy where you have a project ready to go from scratch, and you can start building on all these different things that we have throughout Docs to show you the really cool features that we have within Hasura. Additionally, like I said, since we're using Hasura Cloud for this and we're going to be writing our handler locally and serving it locally, we're going to need to tunnel that from our local machine to the cloud so it's accessible there. We're going to use a service called ngrok, which you may or may not be familiar with, completely free for what we're doing today. It's been around for probably close to a decade and has some really great features within it. Couldn't be simpler. You'll see it in just a little bit that we'll just write ngrok HTTP 4000, and it'll go ahead and create a nice little tunnel for us that we can actually have this endpoint accessible anywhere on the internet. So that means Hasura Cloud will be able to talk to our local handler that we're writing, and that's as easy as it gets. And the next step, we're gonna go ahead and take a look at VS Code and look over configuration, and then go ahead and start writing this handler. So to begin with, we're gonna take a look over here at the left-hand side. We have our node modules and this ENV file. Of course, the ENV has things that we don't want to share publicly with all of you, but these are gonna be the secrets that we use within the application itself. Important of which is an OpenAI key, which you will need for this tutorial. In our package JSON, we have a few dependencies here that you can see, one of which is body parser, which is not technically necessary anymore. In reality, Express can handle a lot of the things that it's doing, but I'm an old dog and new tricks are hard, so I'm going to go ahead and keep using it. We're going to spend all of our time inside of this index.js file, so let's go ahead and begin by bringing in our different dependencies and setting up our configuration. We'll begin by requiring .env so we can access those environment variables, and then bring in Express so we can actually create our application later on. Body parser, as we mentioned a moment ago. And then finally, OpenAI, so that we can actually speak to OpenAI and ChatGPT. Next, we'll go ahead and do a configuration object and client for OpenAI. And all we're going to need to do is actually pass in that key. And in my environment variable, it's called OpenAI key. Additionally, we're going to bring in a prompt. I'm going to go ahead and copy and paste this because it's quite long. Prompt engineering is a term nowadays because it takes a lot of effort and iteration to actually be able to come up with these. So you can see what we did later on with that. Additionally, I'm going to go ahead and get my Express configuration out of the way. All right. Now we're going to have a series of utility functions starting with actually sending the review to GPT from the handler. These will be async functions, so we'll go ahead and say check review with ChatGPT, and we'll pass in a single argument of review text. We'll put all of this in a try-catch block. And we'll have a variable called moderation report that is going to essentially contain all the information that ChatGPT returns. And the content that we're going to pass it is going to be the prompt itself that we wrote a little while ago. And then the review text that we're passing in as an argument here. We are using 3.5 because it's just so cheap However, you can use whatever model you would like to. We'll then parse the response that comes back so we can get the actual content or the string that GPT comes up with. And of course, if there's any errors, we'll return those. Go ahead and fix things here. Perfect. All right. So we can actually send information to GPT, but now we need to say what happens if GPT is happy with the review. So we'll go ahead and make sure that that can be updated in Hasura or via Hasura. So we'll create a new function here called markReviewIsVisible that will take two arguments of userReview and ID. And we're going to use our Hasura URL from the environment variables. This will be a post request that we pass through. And for headers, we're going to actually go ahead and do a little bit of authentication, we'll say. We will use our admin secret. And for the body, we'll go ahead and stringify this query. And this will be a mutation that we'll call update review to visible. And we're going to pass in the review ID, which is a UUID. And then we'll update reviews by PK. We'll pass in that value so we know what the ID is. And then we'll set the isVisible field to true. And then we'll return the ID. For variables, right, we're going to go ahead and pass in the review ID from earlier. And that's being passed in as an argument. And just so that we can see things, we'll go ahead and log this to our server. So in our terminal where we're running this, we'll get a log of all of this coming through. And then we'll destructure our response, get data out of it. And then we'll return the updated reviews ID from that. Now, let's say if GPT is not happy and the review contains inappropriate content, we're going to create a new function here called send notification that's going to take that user review, user ID, and then the feedback from GPT. And we're going to do something very similar to earlier, where we're going to go ahead and actually hit Hasura. So this will feel familiar after the previous function that we wrote. Post request again. Make sure we pass in our admin secret here. Of course, that's coming out of our environment variables. And just like before, we'll pass in a stringified JSON body. Our query will once again be a mutation, but this time it's going to be for insert notification. And a number of arguments that we're going to pass in here, including the user ID, the review feedback that's coming out of GPT. So go ahead and pass in these values. Fix that, and then we'll return the ID. And just like before, we'll add our variables here, which are the arguments that this function is taking in. Now, user review hasn't been used yet, but we will here in the console log. So just like before, we'll have a little bit of information saying this is not visible to users, and then we'll use that review, that first argument that we have in our function. And we'll add another little note here that just lets us know that the user has received a notification and what that notification contains, what that feedback is, which I realize is kind of going off the screen here. And then like before, we'll go ahead and destructure the response and get data out of it. And then we'll return that as well. All right. So at this point, we can actually go ahead and have our handler. So we'll do for post here, and the endpoint will be check review. And we'll take the request and response. And this is the auth that I was speaking to a little bit earlier. We can actually pass a header in. So we can use this key that we came up with secret authorization string that we'll use in the actual handler on Hasura. And we'll say if the auth header doesn't equal this string that we're passing in, then we're gonna return, I think, a 401 and then make it unauthorized. And we'll fix our mistake here. Lovely. Now, if everything's okay and we had the response header, or rather the auth header correct, then we need to actually parse the review from the event payload. And we can do that by doing request.body.event.data.new.text. And then the same thing can happen. Instead of .txt, we'll get the user ID out of that payload as well. We can then take that information and send it to GPT. So we'll await the function that we wrote earlier, which was check review with ChatGPT. And we'll pass in that single argument of user review. And then depending on what comes back, so if is appropriate, meaning everything was fine, we'll go ahead and mark it as visible and pass in the arguments that it needs. And if it's not, then we'll set a notification, again, passing in the arguments that it needs. And just so we can have everything come full circle, we'll actually send a response to Hasura as well that contains the report from GPT. And then we can go ahead and start our server down below. We'll run this on port 4000. And we'll just have a little notification there for the console. At this point, we are good to go and we have everything we need for our handler. Next step is to head to Hasura and get this moving. So to begin with, we're going to go ahead and open our integrated terminal inside of VS Code and start the server. We can see it's running on port 4000. So we'll open a new tab here and we'll pass ngrok the same port. And we can see this is our forwarding address that we can use. If we jump back over, we'll just leave that open because we're going to be able to see it in just a moment. But let's go to the events tab and we'll click create and we'll name this moderate product review. We'll choose our default database and our public schema. And the table we care about is, of course, reviews. And the operation we care about is on insert. So we'll select that. Now here for our handler, we can come back over to ngrok and we can go ahead and copy this address. And as we can see inside of our code, if you remember correctly, we are using /check-review as the endpoint. In our advanced settings, we'll go ahead and come in and under headers, let's take a look at what we wrote. Secret authorization string as the key. And then as the value, /super_secret_123 string. We'll make this a post because that'll match what we have inside of our application here. And then we'll click create event trigger. From there, we can go ahead and go to the API tab. And I'm gonna bring in an appropriate review. We'll go ahead and run it and we can see that it's inserted. And now this has come through from our server, approved, wonderful. Now let's take one that would not have a high rating. And you can see we have this placeholder text in here. We're not gonna write inappropriate things, but we are going to use an emoji because it actually works really well. So we'll say, what a piece of, and then we'll put the smiling poop emoji in. And if I hit run, we'll see the new review came through. And in our server, hey, review flagged, and we can see all this information that comes through, including why the review is flagged, which is the notification the user gets. And just like that, we have instant content moderation using Hasura and ChatGPT. I hope you enjoyed building this today and can see how easy it is to integrate ChatGPT with your applications using Hasura. Of course, this works as a template and you can totally transform it to your own needs. But if you'd rather have a ready-made handler, we've created a repository for this and you can find the link in the description below. Simply follow the instructions in the README and you can deploy it anywhere you can host Node applications. If you're curious about this or other resources we have, check out the docs links in the description too. And if there's videos you want to see, let us know in the comments. Thanks.